Okay, last video we have seen the first part till the where this father of Frankie and the Otto on and the Dan and the doctor was died, and this lady Anne Frank remains in front of this gas chamber the Jewish people are putting inside. That was with courageous you are standing. So the thing we have seen now begins. Later in autumn that year, she and her sister were taken to Belsen between the Berlin and Habsburg. A friend who saw her reported that she was cold and hungry, her head shaved and her skeleton like from the drafted in the horses, shapeless stripped crab of the concentration camp. And it was a terrible things they had done. Okay, they take out their hair, stripping their hair, removing their clothes, shameful things they used to do that. Okay, and she sees that in the concentration camp. She was pitiful, weak, her body racked by the typhoid fever. Okay, with the fever she was like this. Okay, she died early in March 1945, a few days after Margot. The bodies were buried in the mass grave. And the mass grave, the not particularly whose grave it is, everybody is buried there. The mass group of people buried. Okay, that is the thing. And his father, Otto Frank, had managed somehow to stay alive. Okay, and see that. It was said in the beginning he was dead, but he was survived. Okay. He was freed in 1945 by the Russians. In the summer, he went back to Amsterdam. Otto Frank had heard the news of his wife's death. Therefore, he kept hoping that the daughters Anne and Margaret would return. And he had heard the news that wife had died, okay, with the fever. But the daughters would be remain. He was having that hope. 6 weeks later, he learned about the death of his daughters. After 6 weeks, he also came to know his daughters have died. His former typist, Miep, handed him Anne's diary. Miep returned to the annex, Anne's hiding place, a week after the Frank family had been arrested. Okay. She found Anne's diaries in the heap of a paper that lay on the floor. Miep recognized Anne's handwriting and therefore decided to keep the diaries. She did not read them. Had seen, read them, she would have felt compelled to destroy them for a reason of a safety, because the diaries contained detailed information on the help she and her other friends had given to the Frank family. There is a secret. Of the diary which was written was there. It would have been revealed if he had seen her write it, so that she did not read it. Okay. It took Otto Frank many weeks to finish reading the diaries. He broke down after every few pages. He used to cry, broke down, feel bad. His old mother was still alive. After migrating to Switzerland, Otto Frank started copying the manuscript for her. He left out some passages which he left were too intimate or which might hurt other people's feelings. The problem was left out pages was ready to hurt the other people. That was what the danger which he was feeling. He did not have any ideas of publishing the diary. so that he never had this to publish. The professor wrote an article about the diaries in the Dutch newspaper. But one professor wrote this about the diary in the newspaper. Otto Frank's friend now urged Otto Frank to have Anne's diary published. Okay, his friend now tells him, pushes him, forces him to publish this diary. It was very important, the details of this world war which is taking place there during that suffering of these people, especially of the daughter. Anne herself has expressed her desire to get it published. Okay, she wanted to publish that. That is the problem. Okay, she had written, "I want to publish a book entitled The Annex After the War." See, she has written in the diary that I wanted to publish this as a title, The Annex After the War, which Otto Frank finally gave his consent for a publication to well-known Dutch publisher. Refused to publish it. A third publisher published it and sold more than 150,000 copies for the Dutch edition. This was followed by the other edition in Berlin. 250,000 copies were sold. I like number in Japan in 445,000. In the USA, Otto Frank began to receive the hundreds of letters. Most of them were written to express their admiration and grief and the difficulties. See? It was, they said, it was a shame for the other people. No, it was a very valuable things to be noticed and published of this girl which she has written, Anne Frank. Because they want to know the problem of the Nazis. How they made them to suffer, how they have undergone the problems of this life during the war. Whole world must know. And that is the idea she had. So that after her death, she wanted to publish this. Because some secret life of her is involved. After the death, nobody can blame to anyone. So that she was very clever, very shrewd to know things and wanted to publish this after her death. Okay. Girl, the Anne's age, proved out their troubles. Numerous people sent a small presents. Some equid dolls were made for him by the Japanese girls. A Dutch sculptors presented him the statue of Anne. On the birthday of Anne and the Margaret, Paolo was arrived anonymously. Okay, on her birthday, the anonymous and the uncountable people have reached to their birthday. Otto Frank became passionate about the care of the daughter's diary. That is because his mission in life and to retire from business. From the business he became the retired and only to sell his books he was ready. He devoted all the royalties received from the sale of his daughter's diary to humanitarian causes. Letters kept pouring in, which sadly remained him of the losses of the heart suffered. He had suffered. A letter which he received from the headmistress of one of the England's largest schools consoled him to large extent. A letter said, "It must be a source of deep joy for you." This is not the shame, but this will be the source of a deep joy, full joy for you. All your sorrow to know that Anne's brief life is, in the deepest sense, only just the beginning. This is just the beginning for every girl. This is the highlighting idea for these girls, those who are there. And Anne's life was a marking life of somebody. The people of Germany appear to be completely ignorant about the bestiality of the Nazi regime, who had inflicted unimaginable atrocities of the Jewish, and the Anne's revelations in her diary disturbed the people very much, and they are very much disturbed by the Nazis' cruelty or the unbehavior of the people, which is their Nazis, and this was recognized by all the people, especially by the German people. And this was a eye-opening for the people of Germans, those are in the later. It also scared many book sellers so much that in 1950, when the first 4,500 copies of the Germans edited of the Jones Diary came out, they were reluctant to put it in their windows. They are very afraid to put that in front of the people. And that was the story is very interesting to know, because of the one story which was supposed to be a hidden one, but here she makes us to realize the tragedy of death which they are going through because of the Nazis governed by these people in the World War II. So she was the lady who was suffering and she had put in front of this. Let's see further. Anne's diary was made into a play of a Francis Goderich and Albert Hackett, and is one the Pulitzer Prize for a drama. And this became as the manuscript for the drama play of these two people. Who's it? Francis Goderich and Albert Hackett. Okay, this was made as a drama play. In the year 1956 and 57 season alone, it was staged in the 20 different countries to 2 million people in London. It ran for nearly 6 months at the Phoenix Theatre. Later it was made into a movie by the 20th Century Fox. You see, this was made. First it was played in the drama in all over the countries. Especially he says here 20 different countries it was played and gained a lot of money. Who is gaining now? The father of and the Otto Frank. See? And later in the year they made it as a 20th century movie by the 20th Century Fox. Okay, that was run by the Hollywood movie. Anne's Diary was made into a play. When the play opened in 7 German cities simultaneously, continuously, one by one, packed audiences received Anne Frank's tragedy in a silence with a heavy remorse, heavy sadness, remorse. It was reported that the Dusseldorf people did not even go out during the intervals. Imagine. The people not even going out for the interval, just waiting to see what is there for next. Clear? They sat in their seats as if afraid to the lights outside, ashamed to face each other. Kuno Apple, the Dunlop preacher, remarked, Anne Frank has succeeded because it enabled the audience to come to the grief of the history. Personality and without denunciation, we watch it as an indictment in the most pitiful terms of inhumanity to fellow men. No one acts as the Germans, we accuse ourselves. And you know, because of this, the Germans in the Second World War, they suffered a lot by the Nazis. And they wanted to take advantage of it. After the World War, they became the very famous, the earned men. They were trying their best to do everything in the world. And because of that also, you see, till today, if you go to the German, they are more generous for any purpose. They simply pour out the money without thinking. So it is because the suffering which they gone through the Nazis, which make them to understand the problem of the whole world today. That is true. The people are going with the difficulties and the problems, they understand the pain of the others. And that is what the things, this was Anne Frank, was made the whole world to understand the problem which they gone in the concentration camp. Okay. The government, the post-war administrators, which came to the power after the death of Hitler and the Second World War, strove very hard to make the people feel the senseless and the criminal nature of the Nazi regime, but failed. They made to understand, they tried to make them to understand the Nazis, the Hitler, which has made the difficulty for the people of the Germans, and the government failed to make them to recognize. Okay. On the other hand, the diary of Anne Frank succeeded in opening the eye of the common people, who made them to understand the real pain which they have gone through, the diary that the Anne wrote. And that was the only people who could know exactly what had happened. Actors who staged the play received the dozens of letters in which the Nazi informed the actor that he was a good Nazi, and until he saw the play, he had not realized what it was to be Nazi. He was actually a good reader. After of the play, he was taken to act in this movie, and he understood what is exactly the Nazi people were, how they had behavior, how they had made the people to understand. German school children wrote to Otto Frank telling him that Anne's diary had opened their eyes to the viciousness of the racial persecutions. They have made them to realize the mistake of the Nazis. I opened up this diary. Yes. Consequently, in West Berlin, an Anne Frank home devoted to social work for young people was opened. For the people of Berlin, Anne's name symbolized the spirit of racial and social tolerance. Racial, race problem and the social problem. For both, it is an eye-opener. This is the one. Elsewhere in Germany, an organization named after her was set up to combat remaining trace of the anti-Semitism in Vienna. Money was collected for planning Anne Frank Forest in Israel. Okay, in March 1957, hundreds of young people pedaled on the bikes 120 kilometers in lasting rain in the late flowers on the mass graves of the Berner Mulzin, where the Anne Frank had been buried. And the thousands of people has gone on the pedaling on the cycle. They were used to call the bikes. Okay. Marching towards this barrier place to honor her. Had been buried. A 17-year-old girl said, Anne Frank was younger than we are when her life was so horribly ended. She is more younger than us, but her life was ended with the bitterness, okay, with the pain, horrible ending. She had died because other had decided to destroy her race. She died because the other people wanted to destroy her race. Never again among our people must such disease and the inhuman hatred arise. Hereafter, this may not happen in among this our people. This will be the last in the world who suffered this. The writer concludes, Anne's life is indeed only the beginning. She carries the message of courage and tolerance all over the world. She lives after death. Even she dies. Her spirit in every girl has put it inside. So that he says, still even she is dead, she is alive. Because that is what every girl felt to do and challenge of life.